Hi guys, it's Teresa from the VIA Education Department, and we are here with Storytime with VIA. It is 7 p.m. We do this Monday through Friday live on Facebook Live at 7 p.m. I have some really exciting news for you guys. Storytime with VIA is now going to be available on WVIA.org, our website, so you will be able to actually see all of our past Storytime with VIAs anytime you want. Just go to WVIA.org. And now we should get started with the story. Today's story is Little Libraries, Big Heroes. And I don't know if you have ever seen these before, but these are in a lot of the communities now. They're called Little Free Libraries, and they're usually around public places like parks and municipal buildings. You'll find them. This is a really cool initiative that one normal guy created a couple years back, and it's a book trading system that's for free and it's for kids, so you guys can always have books. So once we get out of quarantine and once we're able to go back to the parks, check the Little Free Library out and get your book. This book was provided by our generous grant funders, so we like to thank them. And all of the books that we actually read for Storytime with VIA are provided by grant funders, so we generally like to thank them as well. This book was written by Miranda Paul, and it was illustrated by John Para or Para. So there's the book. Let's get started. Okay. For thousands of years, people have loved stories about heroes, mythical heroes, historical heroes. Look at all these heroes. Can you guys see? There's a guy fighting a dragon, people flying in a hot air balloon. They even like ordinary heroes, like this guy, Todd. He looks pretty ordinary, right? And there's Todd. He definitely looks pretty ordinary. Here's Kid Todd pretending to be a superhero. There's Kid Todd. In school, he didn't feel heroic, even though his mother had been a teacher who loved books. Reading was difficult for him. He was often scolded for asking too many questions and was told that he wasn't a good student. Todd's mom disagreed. She told him he was gifted and had something big to offer the world. You could do anything, she said. He hoped she was right. I agree with Todd's mom. You could do anything as long as you put your mind to it. Todd studied hard, graduated from school, and got a job. At work, Todd discovered that he liked helping others. But then his mother died, and he became the one who needed help to get through sad times. He missed her terribly. Memories of his mom teaching neighborhood kids how to read gave Todd an idea. He cut up an old door and hammered the pieces together to make a tiny one-room schoolhouse. He stacked books inside, nailed a sign in front on the front, and placed a little library on his lawn. Now he could share his mother's love of reading with anyone who passed by. There was just one problem. Very few people passed by. So here is the little schoolhouse that he created and he put in his front lawn. Now he just needs people to know about it. One day during a rummage sale, Todd's neighbors spotted his creation. Todd told them about his mom. People loved his story. It reminded them of ordinary heroes they knew. Soon, neighbors who had never met before were gathered around, chatting like old friends. They grabbed books, they gave books, and the little library became the center of their neighborhood. So there he is with all of his neighbors, looking at all the books. See all those people who are interested in it? So the idea is it's a book trading system. You give a book and you get a book. Todd felt his nifty box of books had potential. He called up his friend Rick, who was always chock full of grand ideas. Rick thought that they could build thousands of little boxes, like Andrew Carnegie, who once built 2,510 libraries. That's a lot of libraries. They could take trips, like Ludi Stearns, who brought traveling libraries all over Wisconsin. Wait a minute, Todd said. Andrew Carnegie had been a wealthy businessman. Ludi Stearns was a trained librarian. The two of them were just ordinary guys, and they were particularly low on cash. How many libraries could two ordinary guys create? How far could ordinary people spread an idea? They agreed on one thing. They wanted to find out. So there's Todd and Rick. What are they going to come up with to get more people interested? We're going to find that out, huh? For months, they salvaged, designed, sawed, and painted. They learned important skills, such as how to recycle a barn, how to pick out a sliver, and how to convince family members that sawing and painting were fun. That's a big convince. The teens lined up their finished masterpieces and waited for the crowds, but the crowds didn't come. Only one person bought a little library. The freshly built library sat and sat and sat. Uh-oh. So there's Todd and all of his friends and family building the little libraries. And there they are, the little libraries are at the bottom. But no one was getting them. What's Todd going to do? The team spirits withered as they waited. Books are filled with great ideas they knew, but those ideas could only spread if people actually read them. So Todd and Rick decided that if people wouldn't come get the libraries, they'd bring the libraries to the people. And there they are in a truck with all the libraries, spreading them out and giving out to people. But out they went with 30 tiny libraries, planting them like seeds between Madison, Chicago, and Minneapolis. Just like at the rummage sale, folks gathered around. Curiosity lured readers to little boxes. They borrowed and shared books. Here's everybody grabbing books and grabbing little houses as well. Friends and neighbors talked with other friends and neighbors who talked with more friends and neighbors about the books they read and where they got them. It was working. The seeds of Todd and Rick's idea were beginning to grow. A radio interview spread the word about the little free libraries all around Wisconsin. Then a national TV show featured their idea. The whole country seemed to be buzzing about the tiny, anything but ordinary libraries. Here's everybody talking about it. Over the next year, 400 little libraries sprang up across the United States. Each library needed a caretaker called a steward. Stewards were ordinary citizens. Some were even kids, and many of them wouldn't stay ordinary though. They became community heroes. So look at that, one little idea and the whole thing started to spread, and even kids could help out. After Hurricane Katrina devastated her hometown of New Orleans, a six-year-old girl named Nikki collected nearly 2,000 books. She's six, guys. She gave a box of books to every little free library in the city. Then she wrote a letter to Todd and Rick's organization asking for a little library of her own, and she got one. Nikki tucked some of her favorite books inside, and people have been checking out stories from it ever since. So in New Orleans, about maybe 10 years ago, they had a big flood that devastated the whole city. And during that time, a little six-year-old, you can see her in the green dress there, decided that she wanted to spread some joy through books and reading. And so she collected all those books herself and actually put up all these little schoolhouses so people can trade and read books on their own, despite the devastation they were feeling at home. That is pretty cool, guys. And she's only 6 years old. In El Paso, near the U.S.-Mexico border, reading programs were short on money. A librarian named Miss Lopez placed the first little free library in Texas at an elementary school there. With her students' help, the idea spread to more than 50 locations around the city. Soon, families had more access to books in English and Spanish. So there is the school. And they're all the kids looking at the little library. In Western Uganda, a totally different country, volunteers set up a primary school and a little free library within a refugee camp. The women, men, and children who lived there had escaped great violence and had been forced to leave most of their possessions behind. Some of them learned to read from the magazines and picture books they found inside the tiny library. So here is a picture of what a refugee camp would look like with everyone reading. So refugee camps are camps for families and people who are escaping violence from their country. And so going to school and when you're in a refugee camp is a privilege. And these kids are probably so happy to be able to have books all their own in a very dark time in their life when they're in these camps that have very little that they need. As the library spread around the world, more tales of ordinary heroes emerged from within a Wisconsin prison, along a hiking trail in Canada, and in cities across Brazil. Stewards placed little free libraries at a hospital in Ireland, on a street corner in Pakistan, outside a house in South Korea, and near a schoolyard in South Sudan. So there are all the people. And look at this. Todd not only created all of this with this in his town, but he was able to create so much more, and all these other community heroes as well. Today, thousands of ordinary and creative heroes are bringing millions of free books to their friends and neighbors. Today, those friends and neighbors will share them with other friends and neighbors. Today, books will be loved and big ideas will spark. And tomorrow, who knows? Tomorrow might bring another hero story written by you and shared with the whole wide book-loving world. That's right. A simple idea and a little bit of perseverance, and you're able to change an entire world. That's what Todd was able to do, and that's what you can do too. So that's the end of our book, guys. Again, the book was called Little Libraries, Big Heroes, and it was provided from our grant funders. We'd like to thank our grant funders again. Check out WVIA.org so that you could actually check out all of our story times. I know that there are little libraries everywhere within this area. I know there's a couple in Duryea, my hometown, but there's also, I'm sure there's little libraries everywhere. So check it out once we get out of this quarantine. Make sure you check them out as well. And also make sure that you like and subscribe to our WVIA Education Facebook page. We are always posting new content every single day, updates. And of course, you'll be able to get a notification every time that we go live. We will see you tomorrow at 7 p.m. Stay safe, stay healthy, have a good night. Bye, guys.